And excuse me. Hello, I'm Alex from AP Ink. So, today I'm going to be getting into a bit of like a fan art series. I really don't do fan art that much because of copyright and all that. But this is going to be for my own personal Anyways, I've got Batman, obviously. I don't know why English is hard for me today. I'm just going to be using this as reference. A piece of sketchbook paper, a 2H pencil. I'm going to be doing more of a chibi style. So I'm just gonna get into this. I'm thinking maybe more of a action pose. This could be just a personal problem, but I wear a lot of graphic tees. So, like, Batman symbols, Superman symbols, Batman, like, the full figure. But it seems to me that whatever ink they're using to screen tees now isn't good, or it's not the right kind of ink or paint. So the decals aren't lasting. Anybody else have that problem? I have a number of newish shirts that the decals are almost completely gone. And I don't know. I'm thinking I might try iron-on patches, which is what this is going to be for. Okay. I think I'm gonna ixnay my earlier thought about using these for anything. This is just gonna be for fun. So, I'm going to use a faber-castell brush pen to do the line art with. Try and get a bit of a thicker line. Okay, I'm gonna give that a minute to dry. I think the brush pen is a bit too thick to do that oval around the chest symbol, so I'm going to go back in with a Sharpie pen, which is a bit smaller, finer tip. Okay, so the colors for this are like blue, black, gray, and yellow. Yellow. And then I'll do this gray. I think for shading, I'll use this darker gray, and I think this kind of look yellowish orange for the shadows on the yellow. Okay, I'm going to erase the pencil with a kneaded eraser. Okay, I think I'll start with the gray. So this is a Sharpie slate gray. And then I've got Sharpie Dark Matter Gray that I'm going to use for the shadow. Okay, I'm going to go in with Permiere, like a dark blue. Purple probably could have worked with this part too. This dark blue or purple for the shadow in the, or the highlight, whatever, on the black. This might actually be too dark. So orange to add a little bit of shadow. Moving on to black. I don't really have colors that I think will work. For skin color in these markers, so I think I'm gonna leave the bit of exposed skin just the paper color. I'm going to use the darker color gray to color in this cable. I'm tempted to use maybe the light gray for shadow on the skin, but I think I'll just leave it as is. Okay, I think for the last touch on this, I'm going to use white gel pen to kind of highlight the split between the blue and the black. Just to help it stand out a bit more as shadow or highlight. Okay. So my take on a kind of chibi Batman. I'm not sure about the white skin. I do have my colored pencils right here because I was going to use them to help color in any of this, and decided just to go with the marker. I could do it looks like I did get kicked off. Okay. I think I'm going to try this kind of rusty brown just to add some shadow around the mask. not sure about this. The alternative is I could completely cover it in, color it in with this color, and then come back in with the brown to add shadow. Or I could use the orange to finish coloring it in. I think at the very least, I probably already wrote this instead of just leaving it paper white. So this is the same orange that I used to give Okay. I'm hoping that kind of looks like skin. Just to try to even it out. Okay. I think it kind of looks better on camera than it does in real life, maybe? Okay, so again, the reference versus what I drew. I was going to do more, but I'm having internet issues, so I'm going to leave this here. I plan on being back tomorrow about 6:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time for anybody who would like to join me. Other than that, enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you. Bye.